it's a very important staple food in Africa, and it's also a very important crop in Asia and Latin America. Cassava is highly desired for two principal reasons from the point of food security. A cassava is believed to have that inherent capacity to grow under marginal environments from two points: ability to adapt under water stress and ability to produce with low soil fertility. But it does not mean that cassava cannot respond to high soil fertility and good moisture conditions. Cassava is highly flexible in production, and it can be harvested anytime between 7 and 24 months. If you look at the biomass produced by cassava, it's much higher than other crops. So it can stay on the field all year round. But for other crops like cereals, between 3 to 5 months, they are out. But cassava will remain. It opens opportunity to be able to utilize and maximize your land throughout the whole year when other crops are taken out, because generally farmers do intercropping. That is the first point. The second point is that a lot of lands that are considered not suitable for other crops, and these are lands in the dry regions, they cannot be opened up to agriculture if they can be planted to a crop like cassava that is well adapted to drought. That is one advantage it has. And with changes in the climate condition, it means therefore that if you want to ensure that food security is not threatened, you need to enhance the capacity of such crops further through genetic improvement. And that is why cassava is so very important. Compared to other crops, it is considered relatively cheaper, because most farmers who are poor do not have the necessary resources to grow crops intensively. And cassava oftentimes is classified under that category, even though cassava can do well when commercialized. So for farmers who do not have the resources, they find it cheaper to grow cassava. And of course, the canopy also means that they can smother weeds. So under traditional setting, it is considered the choice crop for food security.